In this video, I'll show you how to create simple and complex weights and apply them directly to visualizations and tables. Let's assume that the population we are studying has 60% males. And you can see, our sample only contains 50% males. So we need to upweight, or adjust the value of the gender variable to reflect the population. I'll turn on the weighted count so we can see this change once we weight the data. We can create a simple cell weight or target weight using one variable. There are a few ways you can create a weight, but I like to go through the data set tree over here. This is the weighting interface. We are creating a weight based on gender, so that's going to be our adjustment variable. We have the option to enter percentages or population targets here. I'll use percentage targets and make sure they sum up to 100%. Once you have the targets entered, you can check the quality of the weight by looking at the information in the lower right corner. This shows you the minimum and maximum weight values, effective sample size, and ratio between the minimum and maximum here. To add the weight to the project, click New Weight. A new variable will appear in the data sets tree. Now, we can use the object inspector on the right to apply the weight to an output. Notice how the percentages and weighted counts update. You can see that the weight has been applied because this weight dropdown is green, and the footer has now changed to reflect this as well. While the last example looked at weighting with one variable, you may need to create a weight using multiple adjustment variables. This is known as rim weighting or raking. I'll just duplicate the gender weight I created and edit that. We already have the gender set up from before, and I'll add age as the additional adjustment variable here. And I'll add the targets. Instead of typing them all in, this time, I have my targets saved in an Excel sheet, and I can copy and paste them directly into Displayer. To weight all the outputs on the page, I can select the page in the Pages tree, and then turn on the weight from the Inputs tab in the Object Inspector. Notice how the percentages and weighted counts update. Next, I'll show you how to create a two-dimensional weight. These are handy when different subgroups of your overall sample need to be weighted to different targets. For example, men may have one set of targets for income and women may have a different set of targets. In this example, we will use gender and income. I'll turn on the weighted count so we can see this change once we weight the data. Create the weight from the datasets tree. I'll select the first adjustment variable as income. And to the right, I'll select my second adjustment variable, gender. So my weight will become income by gender. Again, I can either type the target numbers or paste them in. I'll paste them from Excel. Let's have a look how the data changes when the weight is applied from the object inspector here. By default, weights in Displayer are computed for the entire data set, but sometimes it's useful to weight within time periods. For example, if a survey is repeated every month, it may be necessary to weight each month separately. This can be done either by constructing the weight within a subsample of the data or by using the time periods as a variable. If you don't already have one, you'll need to create a categorical variable that represents the time periods and use that categorical variable as the adjustment variable. In this example, I'll use the interview date variable. We'll start by weighting the data using the gender weight created earlier in this video. We're going to edit the gender weight variable so that it recomputes for each wave of data. First, we need to select the gender weight in the datasets tree so the edit option appears in the object inspector. Now click Edit Weight in the Object Inspector. In the Recompute Weights For dropdown, add your Wave variable, which for this example is called Interview Date. The weight will now be calculated separately for each time period category. You can see that the data has updated and is now aligned with the 60-40 gender targets that we set at the beginning, balanced for each wave. As with all of Displayer's weighting, the weights are recalculated whenever new data is imported, so new weights are automatically computed when new waves appear in the data.